Good morning. Rotary International President Ian Riesling's theme this year is making the difference. A lot better than lighting up Rotary, right? And as RI Secretary John Hooko said recently, we are on the verge of leaving the world a gift that will last us as long as humans inhabit this planet, a planet free of poliovirus. How's that making a difference? Bob has been a Rotarian since joining the Rotary Club of Sebastopol in 2007, not that long ago. A few years later, as a polio survivor, he joined the district's Polio Plus Committee under Chairman Larry Myers. Bob was president of his club in 2013-14, served as assistant governor for a couple of years, and is now the district governor for 2017-18. He spent his career as an airline pilot, retiring from U.S. Airways, and then joining Rotary. It's not always just the young people. We've got to look at the retirees as well. Now he says his second career is Rotary. Would you please stand and help me welcome our district governor, Bob Rogers.
First thing, I have a tendency to lower my voice. I'll start out speaking loud enough so everybody can hear. But if I start lowering my voice, you guys in the back can't hear me, just go like this or something. I just think I'm going to talk about polio. It gives you that idea. You all know that we just completed a bike ride. We're starting in Crescent City all the way down to Petaluma. We did very well. The official announcement will not be out for another week, but let me just tell you what the idea was. We had 2,400 Rotarians in our district at the beginning of the year when we figured this out. And you remember 10 March of Dimes, 10 cents? When I was a kid, they had these little cardboard things and you put dimes in them. Okay, so that's what we're thinking of, 10 cents a mile. 350 miles, a six-day ride from one end of our district to the other, $35. I'm betting every Rotarian can afford $35. If all 2,400 Rotarians donated $35, that equals $84,000. But wait, the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation is matching it 2-to-1, and that brings it up to $250,000. That's making a difference. Yeah. So I did have a video, but it's sort of long in the tube, so to show you what we did. But just let me say that this couldn't have been done without all of the clubs along the 101 corridor. President Littlefield, where is he? President Dustin, along with other presidents, are starting their year. They got all these things that they got to do that's going on in their head, and I come along and I say, hey, we got a great idea. We're going to put on a bike ride. Can you guys put us up for tonight when we come to your area? Oh, and feed us too, will you please? Oh, and we need some of those little root arrows on the road. Can you do that too? Oh yeah, I forgot. A rest stop. Can you guys do a rest stop? Yeah, I know you're working in the middle of the day, but it's really important. And you know what? They all did it. They all did it with a smile and a glad heart. And not only that, they took the money out of their own pocket to make this all work. And I have some exciting news next week. But I'm not here just to talk. Pardon me? Say it again. It's not only my voice.
Will we write that check too?
The Rotary Foundation.
Bless you. The Rotary Foundation. And then in the middle section, put Polio Plus.
Thank you.
You just touched my heart. But I'm not here just to talk about polio. I mean, we are making a difference. I think you guys all know 10 cases right now so far this year. I have to say one other thing about this. And we get donor fatigue. We think, we've been doing this for 30-some-odd years. When's it going to end? Why can't we, let's go after a parasite or something. This is 99.99% of nothing. No, it's not. We have to get rid of every single case. Do you remember the measles outbreak a couple of years ago in Disneyland? A foreign visitor brought measles to Disneyland, and it spread, infected children there, and it spread in California, New Mexico, Arizona, state of Washington, and state of Illinois. State Board of Education at the time said that 93% of our five-year-olds were inoculated against the measles virus. 7% were not. That virus found was 7%. Okay, coincidentally, at the same time, 93% of the children, the kindergartners, were inoculated against polio. 7% were not. What if that child had brought over the polio virus? That's why we can't rest until we're all gone, and then we have to do that 3 years thing. You know, $1.6 billion, a lot of money, that's what it's going to take, because we have to inoculate every new child in the world that's born. But the good news is 1.2 was pledged at the Atlanta Convention, so we're only $400 million short. So, you know, we're going to do our part with $400 million. Okay, but I'm here to talk to you about some other things, too. You know, the theme for this year's conference is Rotary, where dreams take flight. I'm a retired pilot. I had to get the word flight in there somehow. But it really is true, because every achievement, every innovation, every step forward in this world begins with an idea, a thought, mentation, perception. We see the world around us and we think, whether we perceive it or not, first of all, is a matter of focus and attention. And we think we see the world as we take for granted what we see as that's the way it is. But what if we could set that notion aside? We might become open to other possibilities. Like the Rotarian in the Philippines in 1979, who looked around him and stopped taking what he saw for granted. Polio was a leveler of children, a destroyer of adult lives. The room of so many possibilities, so many futures. Potential and hope were no longer in a complex equation of life. Doors were forever closed, windows forever blackened by the unbidden, dispassionate, undeserved gatekeeper between promise and tragedy. He stopped taking this for granted. He saw a better way for a better life for those not blessed as he was by the accidental freedom from this place. The delivery system was here, that was Rotary, and we had the vaccine. Necessity of action gave birth to an idea, the idea that we could really get rid of this plague. Belief led to a dream. First his country, and then the world. And the belief and the dream fueled this Rotarian. And from there, all Rotarians believed the impossible, to think the unthinkable, to think that we could reshape the world, and to dare to do so. And here today we stand on the brink of a world without polio, because we saw, we thought, we believed, we dreamed, we dared. So where else have we seen a process like this? Walt Disney in his younger years experienced the trash-ridden, cheap and tacky rides and distractions that were the amusement parks of his youth. He thought he could do better. He thought he could fashion a place of suspended disbelief, immersion into a world excited and colorful, a family destination with exciting places to explore like Tomorrowland, Frontierland, Fantasyland. And he dared to make it so. A story about a couple of workmen putting the finishing touches on Disney World, and one says to the other, you know, isn't it a shame that Walt didn't get a chance to see this before he passed away? The other guy looks at him and says, what are you talking about? He did see it. That's why it's here. Think, believe, dream, dare. Disney's motto. The rest is history, the rest is the future. A future filled with perceptions, shared vision, and the courage to act. What was the name of Steve Jobs' company after he left Apple? What was the next company called? Next. Pixar. Can I see your thing? And Frank Lloyd Wright, when asked what his favorite project was, he said, the next one. Another story going around is a guy standing on a beach covered with starfish. They're stranded there by the tide latch, and he's picking them up one at a time, and he's throwing them back into the sea. He's approached by a stranger, and the stranger says, what are you doing? How do you think that you can make a difference with such a massive need? And he picks up the starfish, looks at the guy, and says, you know what? It makes a difference to this one, doesn't it? And he tosses it back in. But let me put it to you another way. What if he had gone back into town and told his friends about the plight of the starfish? Who knows? Maybe his friends were Rotarians. And shared his vision of what could be done. And together, we shared the purpose. They went back to the beach, and they cleared that beach of starfish. Now, I have to ask you, who benefited the most from this? Starfish? The people who came together to save them? Or both? I'm going to contend both, because obviously the starfish were alive, right? But the people who came together to save them received so much more than they gave, huh? For I put it to you that when we perceive a need and share a vision and act on it, in a way we're saving ourselves. We make our livings through our work. We make our lives through our actions. Some even say we make our lives through Rotary. Service above self is more than just a motto, isn't it? It's a way of life, an emotional and spiritual fulfillment, if you will. And indeed, what's the purpose of all of our community service projects? All the things we do, if not for unity of these values. Last night at the board meeting, and even this morning, hearing about what you guys do, such a phenomenal reach, international reach, from Arcata, California. I'm so impressed. Botswana, I heard about last night, and I'm hearing about Pakistan today. We're serving with our talents. Everything you guys do just really blows me away. But, like Steve Jobs says, what's next? Where are you going to follow that after this? Now, you know, I'm not here to tell you what to do, because nobody knows your community better than you. Nobody but you sees the needs. Nobody but you see the starfish. Nobody but you can come together and save them. We all joined Rotary for various reasons. I heard some last night. I had my own reasons, which didn't even come close to what it is now. But you are all still here because you believe in service above self. Like I say, your passion fills my passion. You guys bring tears to my eyes at times with the things you do. You fill my spiritual cup for that, I thank you. Hey, the video, should we help? Well, we have the visual. You know, nothing would be complete without a technical glitch. Okay, here we go, one more time. Our first district assembly, I'm walking down a pathway when out of the blue, a voice behind me says, how old were you when you had polio? What? I say, swinging around. How do you know I had polio? He says, I can tell by the way you're walking and swinging your leg.
What's he talking about? I didn't know I walked anyway but normal. But I can't deny his observation. He's right. I had polio as a child. He introduces himself as Larry Myers, our district's polio chair and fellow polio survivor. We talk for a couple minutes, then part ways, going to different classes. I see him at the end of the day, and he asks me to join his committee, and I accept. A few months later, he asks me to fill in for him on a polio talk he's giving for a fundraiser. I say yes, start doing research as prep for the talk, and soon realize the scope of her fight against this disease. But the real revelation for me is how Rotary got involved in this effort in the first place. It all starts with one person's dream. In 1979, when Rotarians worldwide are asked to come up with a vision, a dream, and a project, Philippine Rotarian Dr. Benny Santos replies, "If you supply us with a polio vaccine, I will mobilize my fellow Rotarians and we will inoculate our 6 million children and eradicate polio from our country." And amazingly, wondrously, that's exactly what they do. It all starts with one person's dream. In 2013, District Governor Helene Campbell asked district presidents to do a water project. In South Ukiah, Rotarian Salvador Rico decides to dream big. He decides to clean up the Ameca River near Puerto Vallarta. He and fellow Rotarians in Mexico even convince the local Mexican governments to donate large sums of money toward the cleanup. And he's well on his way to getting a global grant approved for his project. It all starts with one person's dream. But it's not just the big dreams. Small dreams can grow into something significant for your community as well. Like Sebastopol Rotarian Mark Sell, hardware store owner who sees teachers coming into his store buying items for their classrooms out of their own pockets. He wants to help, so in 2003, during his year as club president, he creates the Teacher Mini Grant Program, where teachers apply for small grants to purchase necessities for their classrooms not being funded by the schools. To fund the mini grants, the club starts an annual crab feed, and this year surpasses $250,000 raised for teacher mini grants. It all starts with one person's dream. Or another not so big idea. Some years back, Rotarian Walt Fisher has the idea of installing a self-delivering dog water spigot in the local park in town. And the idea spawns another idea. And today, that dog water spigot has grown into what is now a full-blown dedicated dog park, where dog owners take their pets to socialize, do their doggy business, and as a result, keep the rest of the park in pristine condition. A win-win for everyone. It all starts with one person's dream. And it's not just dreams about projects. How about the Napa Club's dream to grow Rotary and begin the Santa Rosa Club back in 1921? Who then begins the Sebastopol Club, who then begins the Russian River Club, who then begins the Healdsburg Club. Do you see a pattern here? And just imagine the programs and projects that grew out of each of those clubs over the years. All because Napa Rotary had the idea to start another club. And so, as we move into the new Rotary year, I urge each of you, dream, big or small, modest or audacious, out of the blue, your idea can take flight and soar to heights beyond your wildest dreams. One person's idea can make a huge difference. What's yours?
Okay, so take out your smartphones. These have just taught me how to do this. mark down May 18th through the 20th, 2018. That's going to be the district conference. It's going to be held at McClellan Air Force Base. McClellan Air Force Base?
What the heck is he talking about?
It's retired Air Force Base. corporate space. They turned it into a commercial venture. The bachelor officers' quarters have been converted into hotel rooms. The officers' club is now the hotel, restaurant, and bar. And they took a hangar and converted it into this really cool conference center. There's also an aerospace museum on the premises that we're going to have a cocktail reception now. And if there's any pilots or wannabe pilots in the room, this is going to be your chance to try your hand, because we're running 6 simulators for you to see if you can keep the shiny side up. And even while you're drinking, fly, because I mean, cocktail reception. I'm going to try it. And they're also a full motion simulator. There, you don't control it, but it gives you quite a thrill, quite a ride. It gives you a brief history of the video while you're in there, of the history of aviation. We are going to do things, we hope, very meaningful to you there. We're going to have some hands-on projects. And it's almost a pun when I say hands-on. There's a prosthesis, a very inexpensive one, for $50. And it's nothing like we have available to us here, a sophisticated hand. This is a very simple hand, but it's a life changer for folks in the developing world who have lost a limb from terror or war, or from birth. We're going to put together 50 of those. You're going to feel good about yourselves when you do this. Another thing is a Rise Against Hunger. Is an organization that works with Rotary like ShelterBox does. And matter of fact, they were at the Atlanta Convention and they put Peggy worked on it. We put together meals. You're packaging high protein meals at the cost of 27 cents each. We're going to do 10,000 of those. They did, I think, 400,000 meals or something like that at Atlanta. So 10,000 is the minimum, and we do have a budget. So we're going to package those, and these are going to go to folks in the world wherever it's needed. And I mean, with everything that's been happening with the hurricanes lately, that could be Texas or Florida. For some, ours will probably be going somewhere else by the time we get to it. But it's another feel-good project and another doing good. And you guys are internationally minded. I can see that. And just let me say one other thing that's not on the...
You have a basket?
We have a few...
You have to
put a basket. Oh, we have to have some basket. I'm so touched by with the international projects, and I keep looking over at Captain Infinity here. Because you're doing things for people that you'll never meet, that you'll never see. But you know in your heart what you believe. And in the service of myself, if I've ever seen that. Okay, there's this concept. Some of you may remember from last year when past district governor Wolf came by. He says, rather than give the district governor a gift, a speaker's gift, why don't we do a gift basket and we auction it off? So his club made the first basket, and he took it to his first district governor visit. That club auctioned it off, with the proceeds going to the Rotary Foundation, and then they gave him a basket to take to the next one, and so on and so on. So I asked the presidents this year, while we were training, if they thought that was a good idea, and they said, yeah. I said, okay, we'll repeat it, but I just have one caveat. I would like it to go to polio instead. So these are supposedly put together with about $200 worth of retail value in them. But of course, it's much more than that. You're giving from the heart, right? So this is a basket that came from, where have we been?
Santa Rosa.
Santa Rosa, thank you. No, Santa Rosa Sunrise. Okay, and it's got a coffee, a little coffee, drip coffee brewer set up in there, and various coffees and chocolates. And it's a good thing it was in a vat, because as we drove up here, I was thinking about the chocolate. And I couldn't get to it.
And a nifty basket, too.
Does this club have somebody who fancies himself as an auctioneer?
Ray's usually our auctioneer, but we've got, I know, plenty of people in here that can do it. Anyone want to volunteer to be the auctioneer? Okay, I will.
Okay, you got 4 minutes. I'm just telling you, you don't have a lot of time.
All right, so let's start the meeting. Actually, Terry, you know about this a little bit. You want to give a brief description of the...
Oh, Oakville Grocery Store is in Healdsburg, where that basket's from, and it's a fabulous, you just want to walk in and smell it just for a while because it's so wonderful, and then you can buy a sandwich or cheese or coffee or fresh fruit, anything
whatnot.
You want.
Yeah,
yeah. Whatnot.
So let's start the meeting at $100. Do I have 100? 100, we want to go 120, 120 out there.
Is this for the Rotary Foundation?
Yes. Mm-hmm. This is for the Polio Plus.
Okay. So will we be giving her the money to deposit to the foundation?
Yes.
Or you could be walking out
there? Make it out to the Rotary Foundation and it counts towards your Paul Harris. And Bill and Melinda Gates is going to triple it. What's not to like about this?
We have 500 right here. You have 520. All right.
You said 4 minutes.
Wait, I can talk for 2 minutes. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
We're pushed up against time here. This photo day. Allison, did you? Oh,
don't we have a basket to go to the next Rotary Club?
Yes, we do.
Oh, yeah.
Tell us about that.
So this is a humble themed basket. So a couple of us put together some stuff that's just strictly humble. We have a humble t-shirt and hot sauce, Kinetic coffee, chocolate banana slugs, some Dick Taylor chocolate in here, wine and jam and tomatoes, and a bottle of humble vodka. So it's static brand with humble themed stuff. And silk from Kalisha. She's in North Bay Road acting. She does this amazing silk. So we
have that around. What club will I go to the next club?
Where are you going next?
We're going to Mendocino next.
Okay, Mendocino. So, yeah, we're really excited to pass this along. It's kind of heavy, so be careful.
Okay.